Hi, good evening, good morning, good afternoon, everyone. Hope you're well and have had a wonderful weekend and week. It's been a while since I've caught up with you, so I thought I'd just do a quick live this evening just to see how everyone's doing. I hope everyone's fine. I've already got a message coming from Susan Day, so thanks for tuning in. I hope you're well. I've also got in the background, not very clear because she's actually in the car at the moment, Elima. She's joining us from, I would normally say, sunny Bournemouth and Brighton, but obviously it's night time. How are you doing there, Elima?
Yeah, I'm good, thank you. I'm just on my way to Bournemouth. My other half is driving. Thank
Okay,
you.
good. It's good. So we're going to bring her in shortly. So a question I have for some of the viewers, and particularly for yourself as well, we can discuss this as well, Alima. I feel I'd like to ask you how people have been. What have we done this weekend to really connect with our inner self, our inner feelings, and things like that? Because the point I'm trying to make to some of the viewers that I'm talking to is, what have we done? We have our usual routines of work, business, or whether it's looking after the family or whatever. We have our usual day-to-day routines, if you like. So my question is, do you have a specific routine in which you take time out for yourself to maybe connect with what you're trying to do and with what's going on with your internal dialogue? Is that something you do from time to time, Lima?
Yes, in a way, I suppose I have, in a way, even though my daughter was home for the whole weekend, I've kind of been reflecting about what's the big empowerment weekend next week, and sort of trying to sort of put everything in order of what I'm going to be actually giving the audience, because obviously I want to go on that stage and actually own it, and it, so people can have something they're gonna learn from me about delivering, some different type of health support about single parenting.
Okay, that's good. I mean, for those of you who don't know or haven't been heard, obviously we've got our what we call our empowerment weekend next weekend, in which we've got 45 international speakers all coming into one place under the Yes You Can Inspire to Achieve. As Alima mentioned, she's going to be on stage sharing some insights, some of her knowledge, some of her experience. I'm going to be speaking on stage. We have the rest of the 12 on stage, and for those of you who know some of these names, you have people like Douglas Vermeeren, Raymond Aron, Greg Walker, Andy Harrington, and many other accomplished, authors, people out there that are actually changing lives, impacting lives in positive ways, that are basically there to share some of their knowledge, share some of their insights, and maybe hopefully change people's mindsets, change their perceptions. Because for me, that's what it's all about. As part of my journey, it's about connecting with the like-minded individuals, raising your vibrations internally, as well as improving your mindset, where you're looking to go, whether it's in your personal life as well as within your business. And for particularly for myself, I've connected with Alima literally only last year. I met her at an event somewhere else. We connected, and then our paths were crossed again. She came to our wellness event on the 13th of January, traveled all the way down from Bournemouth. I dropped her in it on the deep end. I said, right, as an appreciation, I get you up on stage. She got up on stage for the first time ever, spoke in public, delivered some great content, some great insights, some great messages. And we had some good exercises throughout the day in relation to different therapies that we were doing. And now she's joined Yes You Can Inspire to Achieve to take it to the next level, to stand up in front of 2,000 people over the weekend. Not that I'm trying to scare her or freak her out or anything, don't think about the numbers, but it's just, it's about, and what I really like about you, obviously, is we've connected. I think you're a great person, you're amazing, but it's just you're taking that commitment now, which is what I try to install in other people when I'm talking to them, is taking it from interested to committed, and then putting yourself out there and getting comfortable being uncomfortable, and that's
Yes.
what it's really about. That's the only way we're really going to truly grow, evolve, learn to connect, and see those real changes within our business and within our personal lives. Because at the end of the day, it's how we're really feeling when we go to bed at night, and those feelings and emotions are important, as well as how we can impact people's lives in a positive way. So what are you hoping to get from the weekend? I know you're going to be working on your content and what you're going to be delivering and owning the stage with your message, but what do you think others or yourself can actually take away from the event as well?
Well, I'm going to be doing a couple of broadcasts this week myself. I'm doing one on Tuesday at 7 and another one on Thursday, and I'm hoping to fit a third one, hoping in brackets, sort of talk about the empowerment weekend. I'm really, really excited about this whole weekend, and obviously I'm stepping out of my comfort zone, and I'm just really so overwhelmed with this all excitement, and it's actually the days are so near now. We've only got like 5 days in 5 days' time, 5 6 days, but Saturdays, and it's 5 6 days. So I'll be
Yes.
traveling to London on Friday. I'll be staying over till Monday afternoon so that I could actually be relaxed to be able to, sort of absorb all what I'm going to be learning from people like yourself and all the other international speakers and the local ones in London as well. There's going to be so much to grasp and comprehend. It's not just about me going out there and giving something out to people. I'm going to be learning myself a lot of stuff because I'm on the beginning of my journey as well. And I'm really sort of I'm going with an open mind, as I said earlier, and I'm out of my comfort zone, but I'm so glad that I did that last year. Obviously my life changed from last year, September, when we met in last September, wasn't it, that we met
Yes,
first
that's right.
in London. And it's 4 months ago and my life hasn't been the same. And I'm really, really enjoying this journey. I've come across a lot of challenges and I'm out of my comfort zone, but I'm so glad that I've taken that leap of faith to actually do that. If I hadn't done that from September, I wouldn't be where I am now, and I didn't expect things to be moving, to have moved so quickly in my life. But for some reason, because I've been taking me on as
Maybe.
one of the family of 12, and obviously knowing you before that, and Maxine, all these lovely people that I've met, I met on the 13th, and I just feel like I've got an extended family now in London, and it's a
That's
lovely
right.
feeling to know that somebody would know what it's like to have challenges during this journey, and people that can relate to that, and that is really good in a way.
Yeah, I mean, I think you sum up perfectly. We're all on our journeys at whatever stages we're at. It's all about being open-minded, being that sponge. And I think the more that you develop and evolve, or as we all do, the more we actually learn. It's not just about us speaking, it's about
No,
what we can pick up from other people as well.
that's
Because
right.
just from some of the lives that I've listened to of other people on the different broadcast channels, where they're interviewing somebody who we class as famous or somebody out there doing it full time on a higher level. It's just those insights, those bits of information, just a random conversation that somebody can pass on to, that you can connect with, that can just really, spark that little seed within our minds and really change lives. I mean, I know it's a bit of a cliche people say that, but for me, I've seen a transition myself as well in myself and those around me, and we just know it works. And the more that people actually, like get off their backside, get off the sitting on the fence and yeah, I'll just go and see what's happening. I'll pay my money and come down. And then they go away with nothing because they're just not open and not hungry to learn and not then dissatisfied. But it's trying to move from, disengagement to engage, to really open up your mind and see, right, let me
That's all right.
participate. What will I get? Not just what I'll get out of it. What can I give? How can I share some information, some insights about my own personal journey? Because we've all got a story. Everyone's got their own challenges. Everyone's had their issues, which has driven them to want to do more, to give more, to be more. And nobody, you shouldn't, earn good money doing something that you love. And especially if you love what you're doing as well, it's an added bonus. So I just want to go through some of the message of the people we have on here. So, it's my friend from that I actually studied with in King's College about 4 years ago. Claudia, how are you doing? Hope you're well. Hope the kids are fine. Hi, Susan Day, thanks for tuning in and thank you for sharing. And Maxine, I see the wonderful Maxine is popping up here. Let me just bring her up now as well.
Oh,
There we go.
bless her.
Ready her up. So, yes, I mean, we've all come on our journeys, we've all got, we're all heading in the right direction. Good evening, Maxine. Can you hear us?
Good evening. I can hear both of you. How are you?
Very
Oh,
well,
we're
thank
good, thank you. Lovely to see you, Maxine.
I've been listening in the background while I've been writing my stuff down, ready for my live at 8 o'clock.
You ready to rock and roll, yeah?
Of course, I'm ready to rock and roll. I'm
I'm not,
always
are
ready to
you?
rock and roll.
I was born that way. So if you've been
Yeah.
listening, what are some of the what are you looking to maybe get from the week, the Empowerment Weekend? Obviously, you're going to be sharing your stories, some of your passion, some of your insights as well. But you know what, for some of the viewers or people watching on catch up, what do you think that for a first timer they could really maybe get if they come with an open mind, you know, and just try and soak up the atmosphere and the knowledge that's been shared?
To be honest with you, whether they're going for life, whether they're going business, whether they're looking to move forward and whatever it is, as long as they take action and they write everything down, because it's all very well going to an event, but the time you finish, you go, that's right, I remember it, but you don't ever remember it. So you just got to make sure you pen and paper, write everything down you can possibly think of, get all them golden nuggets, keep hold of them, and just take action with it the next day. And it's got to be the next day as well. Don't leave it for weeks on end.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I know Aline was saying as well, obviously she's going to
That's
take a
very
day
true.
off,
Yeah.
right?
Yeah, that's
Because
very true.
I know from when we went to LA and we had like 5 intensive days, and by the end of the last day you could hardly remember anything if you hadn't taken notes or made notes in your
That's
phone.
true. Yeah.
And because we're going to be having so many people over the weekend, was over at least 45 speakers, there's going to be so much different content that, you know, if you just zone out for a little bit or turn up halfway through a day, you're going to maybe miss that vital bit of information that was there for you,
The
really.
best
And
thing to
it's good.
do, sorry Rose, the best thing to do is literally if people t some people don't like to actually write anything down. They're just not in their I wouldn't say capabilities, but not in their ideas to actually go, do you know what, I don't want to be writing pages and pages. But even if you put down the speaker of who it is and bullet point the things that are spoken about, what would happen is at the end of the actual event, even if you didn't write everything down, you bullet pointed it, you'd actually see what the bullet points were and go, I remember what that was about now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, true. Yes.
So yeah. So I mean, so hopefully, I mean, obviously, we're all full steam ahead now for the weekend. I won't even discuss the list. I'm sure things we've got to get done ahead of it, as well as obviously sorting out. We've mentioned our own speeches and stuff. But what do you do yourself, Maxine, to take time out, if you like, in essence, and just really connect with yourself? What do you
Oh,
like to
take
do?
time out. Well, do you
I
know
know.
what? To be honest with you, taking time out the last couple of weeks has been non-existent. And you know, when you feel it in your body, you know when it's like, right, I need time now. I need time to chill. I need time to relax because my brain, and I feel like I've got matchsticks and everything else. And the thing is, it does happen. You get burnout. And no matter who you are, what you do, and no matter how many times you go, I mean, I'm like Brad. I'm an Energizer bunny. I could just get going and going and going. But when my body turns around and says, enough is enough, you need to stop. It's very much that I'll just sit in a quiet room, in my room, away from the kids, away from everything, turning everything off and just sit there quietly, even if it's for half an hour. And that's very much what I do because my life is busy, whether it comes down to doing broadcasts, writing content, sorting the kids out, you know, no matter what it is, it's always doing something. So for me to sit there and just do nothing, just have me time, that's probably the best thing for me.
Yeah, I hear what you're saying now. I sometimes do the same thing and I call it a nap, but I'll take your word for it. What about yourself,
I actually
Alina?
did that yesterday. I fell asleep for like 2.5 hours during the day.
Oh, wow.
I know. I know I never
Oh.
do that. So that's when I know my body's saying to me, stop. You need rest.
Yeah, mental overwhelm. What about yourself, Alina? What do you generally tend to do to unwind, take time out, or just to realign and adjust yourself?
She's doing it, she's
Maybe
fell
over.
asleep.
I know. Alima, can you hear us?
Yes, I'm here. Yes, I heard what you said. Yes, I did. Yeah,
So what do
I'm very
you
much awake.
Okay. So what do you do to take time out for yourself, you know, just to calm yourself down, readjust, or get back into balance if things are maybe.
I love going for a walk on the promenade, the beach in Bournemouth.
Oh, of
You know,
course. What a
it's
lovely
kind of
place to be.
you just go there and all you hear is just the waves and the lovely breeze, the sea and the waves coming in, and I find that so therapeutic. And then you
Yeah.
watch people walking their dogs or those lovebirds holding hands and just watching the world go by. It's a different kind of tranquility you get when you walk by the beach in Bournemouth compared to when you go window shopping and there's so much happening around. And it's really, really, I love that. I just sort of get into, I almost feel as if I'm like in a book, you know, sort of reading a book where you kind of feel you're in that presence of that chapter. Sometimes that's how I feel. I'm a bit of a drama queen and I love poetry anyway.
Okay. Now, I mean, that sounds wonderful. I mean, I myself have been, I know what you mean when you go to a beach and just get that different. You also got the salt air as well, which is obviously healing. Mm. You've got the crashing of the waves, the energy coming that's in from like a yin-yang perspective from the
that's
sea.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's really calming as well, isn't it? Yeah, well, we don't quite have that where I live, unfortunately.
No, me neither. That's why I said sit in my bedroom in peace and quiet. But, you know, do you know what? It looks like we're going to Bournemouth in a couple of weeks. Probably a bit chilly, but, you know, and having the sea crashing against the waves or even just listening to it going against the pebbles on the beach. He's very tranquil, he's very calming, and I love that. But it's only in the summertime that I really get to do that. But, you know, that is probably when the sun's going down and you're just sitting there's no one on the beach and you're just sitting there just relaxing and chilling and just listening. And it's just amazing.
Yeah, you're welcome, Maxine. You don't have to wait till the summer.
You
now have an extended family in Dorset. You've got no excuse. We have the beach in New Forest. It doesn't make any difference about the season. You just need to get yourself. You can come on the coach, the train. You know, you don't have to drive all the way here. And just come and see your sister in Bournemouth. Because we're all a family now, aren't we? And the same goes to you, Raj. After the empowerment weekend, we're all going to need that.
We're already planning our first, like, day, our wellness day trip event out to the beach. You know,
good for you.
Check a few pebbles around and just do some exercises. Yeah,
oh,
for
no,
sure.
We don't have pebbles. We don't have pebbles in Bournemouth. That's Brighton. We have proper sand.
I love Dorset sand. It's amazing. Apology,
yeah. But yeah, so I mean, we're looking forward to that, definitely. But getting back to the event, so for all of the listeners, really, what I could really say is, you know, you've got to be in it to win it. As I say, you know, you've got to turn up, show up, be there. Come and participate in the wonderful weekend that we've got. Listen to some of the speakers, connect with people, network. You know, as a man once said, you just make that one connection, that one person,
that's
it can change your life, it can start your journey.
Yes.
You're going off in a totally new direction, in a higher direction, a more fulfilling direction, but you've got to be there. You know, it's okay, there's always be excuses, there's always going to be reasons why not to. And as I call them, the butters, there's always a but. But like I said, you know, commit to yourself, turn up, get your tickets, come, turn up, and enjoy the day, see what you can get from it. If you can't make both days, at least come from one. Hear some speakers, get some great content, connect with myself, Maxine, Alima, Bradley, the rest of the 12, you know. Share some connections and get involved, really, and it will only benefit yourselves in the long run. We're on our journey. You know, we're on our journey. We're going where we're going anyway. We'd love you to come on board. We'd love you to join us, be part of it, and then hopefully change your life and the lives around you. So I'll just leave you two ladies to do a quick summary, if you like, before we jump off and stuff. And then I'll put the link for the Empowerment Weekend after.
Yeah, that's very true. I really would advise people to please just make an effort to come down the next 6 days' time. We're going to be having this amazing, incredible time with the Empowerment Weekend at the Ibis Hotel in Earls Court. Please make time. Just come with your friends, family. Come with an open mind, pen and paper, or a good phone. You can take pictures with, you know, of information on the screen, and you just don't know who's going to be sat next to you. You know, you don't know what kind of friendship you're going to make with the people you're going to meet. There's so many varieties of different speakers that covers every aspect of our lives, and you just don't know. You know, just coming to that one event will change your life forever. You could make a friend. You could meet your future spouse there. You don't know. You could meet your future, who knows, you know. And you really, it's just really, really worth it. £24.50, is that right, Maxine?
It is.
Yes.
Crazy,
yes.
Yeah.
And if you want the VIP, it's 190. It's really, it's nothing, because in the evening, and she spent more than a pound in out, you know, with friends, and that's just per head. And so it's really worth it to just come with an open mind and have a wonderful time, meet all these people with all the friendship you're going to make for life. And who knows, you know, you could be one of the 12 as well. You can be part of our family. And it's going to be, you know, it will be an experience you'll never forget. Please, please, please buy your ticket now.
Perfect. Maxine?
Okay, well, I interviewed Douglas Vermeeren yesterday, and I asked him the question is, how much do you charge per hour? And he turned around and said to me that his average charge is £5,000 an hour. Now, over the space of this weekend, you're going to be getting 12 hours a day for 2 days. So you get a whole 24 hours. The highest ticket price we've got, which is a VIP ticket, is £198.50, which is half price. Now, £198, even if you went for that, you're talking less than a fiver per hour. So put it into this perspective. Would you like to actually go and see one person for 1 hour for £5,000? Or see two people over an hour for a fiver and get half hours worth of information from lots of different people, rather than just learning about one side of your business, whether it's to do with branding, whether it's to do with how to do a website? Wouldn't you like to actually have to know how to do every single aspect of your business? Wouldn't you like to know, say, that you want to go in there not knowing what you're doing, how you're doing it, and the way you're working your business, or even come to it not even thinking about a business and actually walking out there after a weekend saying, I know exactly what I need to do, I know exactly where I need to go, and I've got all the information that I need? So whether you're going to go for £24.50, which is a pound an hour, or whether you're going to come for under a fiver an hour for £198.50 to come and meet all the people out the back, it's going to be worth your while. It's going to be cheaper than if you actually went out for the day, exactly what Lima just said. You know, you going out with the girls, you going out with lads, whatever it is for a night out, is going to be so much more expensive than what you're going to get here, but you're going to get it back 100-fold later on. That's what I'm going to say to you today.
Wow, perfect. I mean, like we've all said, I mean, it's an investment in yourself. How much are you worth? That's the question. Because I think a lot of people undervalue themselves, and it's always about, oh, what's the price? Is it worth it? Should I do this? I'm not too sure. But then how are things ever going to change if you don't invest in yourself? You know, or invest in the latest shoes, bags, I'm stereotyping here, ladies, or whatever the latest phone gadget is. But when it comes to investing in ourselves, a lot of people don't. And that's why some people's lives are changing and some people's lives don't, because they don't put that personal investment in. And the only other bit I'd like to add for myself is, where else are you going to get access to multi-million pound business owners that are out there actually walking the talk, sharing their knowledge, sharing their insights, all under one roof over this weekend? Where else would you meet so many? I can't answer, I don't think you can either, because it's not something that normally happens, which is why obviously under the YYC umbrella we put this event together. And you know, Bradley's been pushing hard for it, so to bring as much content, as much information that you can, hopefully, like Maxine said, take it away, implement it in your lives and change your lives. So on that note, I'd just like to leave that with you. I'd like to thank you, ladies, for your time this evening. Alima, I hope you're doing well. And Maxine, thank you for your time, and I look forward to catching up with you later on online. And
everyone else, thank you very much.
You just
arrived home.
All right, thank you. Oh, well, we'll see what's within the length, yeah? All right, take care.
Okay, bye. Bye.
Bye.